Gumboat Man, and you should subscribe to ZRB. Also, drop a like on the video right now.
Alright boys, I'll be showing you how I make my thumbnails. In the process of how I make them, I'll just be going over through the whole thing, my workflow. Yeah, let's get right into it. Alright, so what I do usually to get the actual thumbnail, I go into my montage. All I have is Premiere Pro and Photoshop open. I'm going to be using Photoshop. You guys can use any Photoshop clone. Or as long as you know how to use your software, you can just follow along. So I just take some aspect of my montage. I'm going to be going okay here where I run into everyone and kill this guy. Right here. Yeah, I'm going to just do it right here. This is what I usually do. This one's going to be hard to do. But I think I can still do it. Alright, yeah. For HUD removal at least. So what I do is I hit Windows, Shift, and S. And then I pause up this and I just snipping tool this. Just like that. And then I go into my Photoshop, create a new thing, make it 2566, 1440. You can do any size, but that's the one I like. And once it pastes in, I just close on my Premiere because you don't need it no more. And then once I'm in, I stretch it out. So one of the main and hardest things to do is the HUD removal part. It's not really hard. It's just messing with the spot heal tool. And I just go through everything. Just like this and get rid of it. So I'm gonna speed up this part of the video of me working on HUD removal. So for big aspects like this, if you can see that my character's back isn't actually on it, so it's not gonna mess it much up. So I can just kind of go over this entire thing. I'm just gonna fill it in real quick. It just depends. If there's a lot of stuff while you're trying to remove, it's hard. But if there isn't like this, you can just remove the whole thing and it should be good. And you can just patch it up a little bit. Fix the weird parts. Make it look more natural. This is like an automatic tool. It does mostly everything for you. And there you guys go. So I'm gonna be doing this everything. I'm gonna speed it up. And yeah, see you guys then. Alright there, so as you guys can see, once I remove this, it looks a little bit weird, but you can keep it like this. Like these aspects, how it kind of looks weird right here. You can actually move it, just make it all gray, because when it gets all bored in the background and stuff, it's not usually noticeable, and not everyone really looks at that detail. Unless it's something huge, like a huge difference, you guys should be good. Alright, I'm about to speeding it up. Alright, so I'm done with it. I'm not going to worry about the top left part since this is only for tutorial, for reference. I'm not going to worry about it. Usually, if this is a normal thumbnail, I'd be taking a hell of a long time because that top left part is really hard to get rid of. I'd probably have to clone and do masking and other cloning things. But usually, I always do just what I did. I just remove the HUD and it looks perfect and it looks fine. So that's why I usually pick spots with not a lot of buildings around it and stuff that could mess it up like it is in a top left right now. I'm gonna just leave it like that for now though. So I'm gonna just get rid of this background because I don't need it. So what you wanna do is you wanna click on this layer and then you wanna hit Control J. That will copy the layer. And then you make sure you wanna select the top layer. You hit Filter, your Blur, your Motion Blur. A good spot for if you're only doing motion blur, I'm gonna add a radial blur to this. But a good spot for motion blur is about 90 to like 150. 150 is like too blurred at that point. But like 80, 100, that's good around there. But since I'm adding a radial blur, I'm only going to do about 48. And now what you want to do is make sure your top layer is selected. And you'll put the opacity down. You want to make sure you're still on the top layer when you select your eraser tool. And now you want to just trace with the eraser around your character. Just pretend like the blur is still there, but you're erasing it away. So you just want to trace your entire character like this. Usually I'd put more detail into it. I'd be taking a long time, but since this is just a reference, you want to put the opacity back up, as you can see. If you want to get rid of that weird hue around the player, you can just keep getting rid of it and deleting it. I'll show you how to fix if there's a big if there's a big difference, and you can see it. You know what I mean, in a sec, after I get rid of this hue around him. Let me do that real quick. All right, so you see how there's kind of like, it's not blurred around them anymore. So to fix this, you can easily get the blur tool, stay on this layer, and then just keep going over it, and it'll get rid of that weird shift sudden change into the blur. So you can just do this all around where there's sudden changes. So like right here, for example, you could do it like right here too, right here, right here. I am gonna have a thumbnail pack within this video though, so you guys don't actually have to do this unless you actually want to learn and make your own. So as you guys can see, you could keep doing this and fix it more, but that's what I do for the sudden change. There's some weird thing where my mask is popping out here, so I'm gonna fix that real quick. I'm gonna just select the bottom layer, pick that with the color picker, go to brush, make it smaller. What the hell? I'm just gonna erase it, but you gotta do it on both the layers. There you go. It's gonna, I could do the whole thing, but that's how I'm gonna fix it if there were to happen. It's just a reference, so you guys can do it. I'm just showing you guys how I make my thumbnails and the workflow around it. So once you guys are done with the motion blur part, I usually like to do the person I'm shooting at or other people. So I'm gonna put the opacity down again for the top layer, pick the eraser, but these guys are further in the back, so I'm gonna make the thing smaller. Eraser really small. Now I'm gonna just trace them real quick, get rid of all the blur inside of them. All these bullshit retards. Get rid of them. Bunch of furries. Alright. These guys kind of deforms, which is how it looks in game, I guess. Just do all of them that are aiming at you, makes you look like a cool kid. Just your big balls. Alright, there, some Muslim should be removed. Yep, there. Alright, and now, since there's this weird thing right here, I'm gonna just bandage tool that. Bandage tool the background too. Alright, that's fixed. Alright. Now, since I'm gonna be doing a radio blur, I'm gonna just go to filter, go to blur. Now, go to blur, go to radio blur. I'm gonna do like 10. There you go. And so now, usually I'd get some kind of emoji or something. So I'm gonna pick it from my thumbnail pack, because my thumbnail pack comes with a bunch of assets too. Let me get it real quick. AP piss, no, that is that other one. Oh, that's a free week. Okay, assets, emojis. So mine has a little bit of emojis. I'm gonna just do, I'm gonna do the clown emoji. I pick it. It's really small, but this is a vector emoji, so the quality should be just fine. I always put a little bit of rotation into it, make it bigger. There you go. That's usually how my thumbnails are made. This doesn't look like a actual emoji, so I'm gonna quickly add a stroke on it. Just for that purpose. Alright, there. I'm gonna quickly export it. I'm gonna show you guys how I export my thumbnails. I'm gonna go JPEG. I always do JPEG. I always think it turns out to be the best quality. This white line just appears for some reason. It doesn't actually appear in the thumbnail. I do preserve details because I think it always has the best quality. 2560 1440. You just copy those settings down. They're just basic settings, and then they export just, you know, like usual. So I have all my thumbnails in a specific folder. So I'm gonna quickly put that in there. Actually, I should just go with my thumbnail pack because I'm too lazy to actually use it. Is it a ZRB thumbnail pack? Thumbnails. Emoji thumbnails. I can't spell. I can't spell for shit. Nope, I can't spell for shit. ZRB Cloud. Alright, let me just save it too. Alright, boys, and that's how I make my thumbnails. I'll show you the thumbnail pack. See y'all in the next video. Peace.